Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Sunday, SpaceX successfully launched their 18th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 639. The booster which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the 13th time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Tomorrow we can hopefully expect to see a Starlink launch. The Starlink 640 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 29th at 3:30 PM UTC or 10:30 AM EST. Following that, we can hopefully expect to still see a Crew Dragon launch this week. The Crew 8 mission is still scheduled for Friday, March 1st at 5:04 AM UTC or 12:04 AM EST. Then, going into next week, we can hopefully expect yet another Starlink launch. The Starlink 641 mission is currently scheduled for Monday, March 4th at 12:19 AM UTC or Sunday 3rd at 7:19 PM EST. Later that same day, we could also see a rideshare mission launch. The Transporter 10 mission is currently scheduled for Monday, March 4th at 2:22 PM UTC or 9:22 AM EST. With the Crew 8 launch coming up, SpaceX posted a picture of the crew. They said Crew 8, SpaceX and NASA completed a full rehearsal of launch day activities ahead of liftoff this week. SpaceX is constantly striving to improve the performance of their Falcon 9 rocket. They posted information about the Starlink 639 launch, saying this mission is carrying one additional Starlink satellite from previous East Coast missions, thanks in part to performance increases on Falcon 9. Also related to this, there was a post with information about how many more satellites they want to try and squeeze onto Falcon 9. It says an extra satellite on the stack is a big deal. The goal of the Falcon and Starlink teams is to get to 28 by end of year. There was an article posted with information on progress at Slick 40 as they get it ready to support crewed launches in future. It says SpaceX is closing in on certifying its launch pad at Space Launch Complex 40 to support astronaut and cargo missions with its second generation Dragon spacecraft. On Monday, the company performed a test of its new emergency egress system featuring a type of deployable slide. Heading to Boca Chica, concrete was seen being poured for the launch site wall. A bunch of tanks were recently delivered to the launch site. In the production yard, work continues on the expansion of Star Factory. Here's a look at the work continuing on the new office at Starbase as well. SpaceX posted information with a link to a press release on their website related to IFT-2. This post says the second flight test of Starship and Super Heavy achieved a number of important milestones with lessons learned that informed vehicle upgrades debuting on Flight 3 as we continue to advance the capabilities of the most powerful launch system ever developed. The press release has information about what caused the booster and ship to fail during the last flight test. For the booster, it says the most likely root cause for the booster rudder was determined to be filter blockage where liquid oxygen is supplied to the engines, leading to a loss of inlet pressure in engine oxidizer turbopumps that eventually resulted in one engine failing in a way that resulted in loss of the vehicle. For Starship, it says a leak in the aft section of the spacecraft that developed when the liquid oxygen vent was initiated resulted in a combustion event and subsequent fires that led to a loss of communication between the spacecraft's flight computers. This resulted in a commanded shutdown of all six engines prior to completion of the ascent burn, followed by the autonomous flight safety system detecting a mission rule violation and activating the flight termination system, leading to vehicle breakup. With this press release, the FAA also gave some information with this article posted about it. It says the Federal Aviation Administration on Monday announced the close of its investigation alongside SpaceX into the second Starship flight as SpaceX seeks a license to launch the towering rocket again. The crane was recently seen detached from Starship 28. Then SpaceX also did some testing of Starship 28 on the Pad B test mount as it awaits Booster 10's return. Starship 29 was recently moved out of Mega Bay 2 and over to the High Bay. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.